watching Nord Tuning. On this episode, we will modify a stock head so it will accommodate a 12 mm lift camshaft.
The first thing to do is to mill out some metal next to the cam follower bores, like so. Here you see a Motronic camshaft. It's as big as they come because the base diameter is 2.5 mil bigger and it has a 11.5 mil lift. So if this turns, everything else will fit. Or so I thought, until I bought this camshaft. This is a camshaft as used in the Squadra Bianca Cup in Holland. And it has a slightly wider lobe, and the lobe seems to be a little bit more off-center than the other lobes from the stock and from the Colombo camshafts. So it's always wise to have the camshaft you want to run in your engine and make a pre-fit. This won't work. For comparison, here we have the 12 mm Colombo camshaft fitted. And there's no problem. So this is the head I'm gonna use. I've bead blasted this head. It cleaned up very nicely. Also the inlet manifold. If you have your head bead blasted, be very sure it's not possible for one single bead to get in the engine. So I do it myself to be sure it's done correctly. I've blocked up the valve guides with Allen bolt keys, and there's some fiber washer behind it, so it's closed. I made this plate combined with some rubber, also a very tight seal. Installed the spark plugs so there's not a single bead in the thread, to demolish the thread. And now we can clean it. It looks clean, but if you wipe it down, you see there's a dust in the aluminium. Although it looks clean, you have to wipe it down very thoroughly. So now for the rebuild of the head. I've installed the first inlet valve and only installed the valve retainer like this, so we can check how much distance there is between the valve retainer and the seal, so we can see how much lift this head will accommodate. Well, for the first cylinder, I found a lift of maximum of 9 mm. Then it was touching the seal, so it's way off. We should look for a lift of 12 mm and then a clearance of 13 mm. So what went wrong? Well, as I installed a few new old stock seals I had. These are the black ones. And as you can see, they are higher than the old ones, the green ones. So there's a difference. We can gain a millimeter there. And then I looked at the retainers, and there are different types, and also within the same type the height will variate. Here could be a difference of 0.6 of a millimeter. So this has to change. And for the second cylinder, I installed the valve with the smallest spring retainer and a smaller seal. And now we can see the lift. You can see the red dial, and it's 11 millimeters. So that's much better. But now we have to adjust some other things to make a 13 millimeter gap. So now for the solution I'm gonna take to overcome this problem. I'm gonna take the valve spring retainers and make them all the same size, and take off 1 mm extra, and I will press down the valve guides 1 millimeter deeper in the head. I have made a tool for this. The left tool is just a removal tool, and the right tool is to install the valve guides to the correct depth. There is a bush, threaded bush, and you can adjust it to the depth you want. So we're gonna do this. I forgot one tip. If you don't have access to a lathe, then use an old valve stem. Don't use the exhaust valve. They are filled with sodium, so be careful with that. Put on the collets backwards and the valve retainer backwards. Give it a light tap so it's fixed. And then with a spinning drill, you can grind it down to the height you want. And it's just a nice, even grind because it's rotating. So I reduced the height of the valve spring retainers to about 10.5 millimeters. This is the maximum. You can see the collets are almost sticking out. So you can't do any more because then the collets will touch the seal and you have the same problem. I also pushed in the valve guides 1 millimeter and I checked all the free play of the valves, and they all are 13 millimeters. I can show you on the dial. Push them in real slow, and it's 13 millimeters. Yep, job well done. It's time now to install the valve springs. So now for the installation of the valves, check if there are any sharp burrs on the valves, so they and remove them so they don't damage the seals. Oil up the valve guide. Let's see, where's my, yep. And some oil on the valve. Spread it nice and even. Install the valve. Okay. Springs. This is a tool I made myself. It's a little bit sturdier than the official tool, so it works a lot nicer. Only a bit slower. So, one done. Now for the next one. Okay, the valves are in. Now we can install the camshaft. This is a 2 liter standard camshaft. It has a lift of 10 millimeters. I can show you. Start here at zero and at the top it's 10 millimeter and 6/100ths of a millimeter. I put this number in an Excel sheet so I can compare all the camshafts. This with the lowest lobe is a standard 1600, also used in the early 1750s and in USA models. These are the two camshafts I'm gonna put in. These are almost similar. A standard 2 liter and a 2 liter Alfa camshaft. They have different numbers, but the lobe is practically the same. You can see here it's a red, and under the red there's a little bit of blue. So in the next stage we're gonna fit in the Motronic or the 2 liter 75 inlet camshaft. They are also almost identical. And for the final stage I will try the Colombo Barini STE1 camshaft. It has a 12 millimeter lift and a little bit more duration. So there is one mod we have to do to the inlet manifold. This is our vacuum pickup point for the ECU, and the original hole is too big, so I welded it shut. The problem is, if you have a big hole and air is passing through the inlet manifold, here the air sort of tumbles over the edge, goes in the hole, building up pressure, and then it goes out again. So it creates an unwanted pulse in your vacuum system. So to avoid this, you have to make the hole much smaller, maximum 1 millimeter. Then the air won't stumble over this edge and just passes right by. So these were the first modifications we do to our cylinder head. I won't be using the vacuum pickup point because I switched from the Tuner Studio ITB mode to the Alfa N mode, which only uses the RPM and the throttle position. But it's always nice to have a good vacuum pickup point to see what's going on in the inlet runner. See you on the next episode.